So we are in camp four for the men this week. Women's are having a kind of down week for a few players, and there's quite a lot involved in the Six Nations as that kicks off. So really excited to see how they go. Certainly ramped things up with the men this week in terms of got ourselves back into sevens play.
The level of intensity starting to increase, and boys really enjoying the opportunity to get into one another, really.
Six weeks ago, we had a blank canvas on what this GB program was going to look like, both off pitch and on pitch. Just the calls, the way they want to play, how they want to be achieving their goals when we get to the Olympics is really exciting.
So I got an injury in the first day of camp number three. So just in the warm-up, just felt something go in my right calf. Was lucky enough to get an MRI scan on it within 48 hours, confirmed it was a low-grade tear. So I'm hoping for 2 to 3 weeks of rehab and then back in and join the boys again for full training. I think when you've added in the added element that there's a selection process going on and there's a limit to the number of days, that adds to it. But I think it's just one of these things, contact sport, you've just got to take them on the chin. I find just still trying to get involved as much as possible. So when you're on the pitch of the side of training, just having a chat with the boys around different calls, how the attack's going, how the defence is going, and then just everything you can control. So what you're doing in terms of your rehab, your weights, your off-feet conditioning, anything like that, just commit to it fully and then just see how long it takes. You can't control it any more than that. And I think that's how I deal with it best. So having the training as a doctor, I don't find it so much frustrating, I just find it helps a lot more. So as soon as I stepped off my right foot, I kind of had a feeling of what I'd just done. Balancing the medical studies and the rugby was, I'm really glad I did it, it was probably one of the toughest things I've done. But it is something that I'm open to going back to at the moment though. Over the last kind of 4 or 5 years, it's all been gearing up towards trying to have the best cracker going to Tokyo, so I haven't thought too much past that at this moment.
My name is Max McFarland.
I'm Jamie Farndale.
My name is Alex Davis.
I'm Tom Mitchell.
Play centre.
I'm a winger.
Prop.
I'm a playmaker and I'm in the Astros.
Part of the Governors.
And I'm part of the Wolves group.
And I'm part of the MCs. We've been split into four different focus groups.
To help with driving analysis so that we can move forward in all the different areas in the most efficient and kind of most detailed way possible.
Our group's the attacking group. We're called the MCs after MC Hammer and his song, Can't Touch This. That's the exciting part of Rugby Sevens, is the offloading, the stepping, the speed, yeah, the pace and power. I think that's what us as an attacking group are trying to get out of this group and see how much we can optimise that.
We're focusing on the defensive area, so how can we work best to break down the sort of harmonious attack? Think of ourselves as a bit of a viciously aggressive unit, but with some underlying, deeper, caring vulnerability to sort of protect everyone around us and protect our defensive line. So yeah, that's our main focus really.
If you look at the other groups, you've got the Governors that do the defence, and I don't think anyone would argue they're too important. I mean, they're just all about getting off the line and tackling someone. I think the MCs and the Astros, the set piece and the attack, they'll probably be busy arguing with each other about who's more important. Restarts are the most important part of the game. It's the biggest source of possession, and also if you win the ball back, then you're attacking against an unstructured defence. So where from set piece you'd be against a defence that's ready for you. If you win the ball back off a restart, you're going against unstructured defence. So the teams that win their regain and receipt consistently will generally win the game. We quietly get on with our thing, and yeah, that's we're the brain power of the operation really.
I think you know you're the most important group when the other groups sort of mug you off and like talk about you behind your back, and then you know, the other groups know. So in the Astros group, we're all 9s and 10s, and with that comes the strength of understanding the game, particularly around the set piece. Combined between all of us in the group, we've been in those situations a lot, but it's also a sort of creative thinking. You know, how can we do things that haven't been done before? And understanding why you might do things in a certain area of the field, in a certain situation in the game, with certain personnel. And it's just being able to throw all these different factors into the mix and come out with a recipe that's going to deliver something to score you tries or stop the opposition scoring tries.
There's a bit of a rivalry when it comes to presenting in our video analysis, and kind of that's where it gets quite chirpy, I'd say.
Instead of just playing to the width and moving in the wide channels and putting the pace on, and then the second receiver does a great job of giving him time to have a go.
Us being the MCs, we're in charge of monitoring what the Astros do and call them up if we see like they've missed something in their analysis, and we presented this week. In my view, is a good analysis. And
I think we also need to start scanning, just scanning what the defence is doing, because a lot of the time the defence wasn't coming up as hard.
The beauty of it is that everyone sees the game differently, and to share that immediately changes your perception of that particular situation. You think differently, so the next time that comes around, it's informed your thinking. You might find different solutions to a particular problem or particular play. So it's really valuable.
Definitely a bit of work on, but it's definitely felt better for me.
There's definitely a competitive element to the groups. There's a bit of mugging off between the groups. The MCs are self-confessed. I don't know if you've spoken to those boys yet. They're self-confessed. The guys in the past that maybe didn't do the work, and they've said this in their own words. And now that they're all in a group together, it seems, they've been forced to deliver. And fair play, they're delivering well, but they're like the guys that didn't study for the test and then get good marks. This is not the normal amount of time, 4 years, like other teams have had to build on this stuff. We're having to be efficient. Meetings like last night really helped with that.
Last time it really took a big toll on me mentally, not making the games. Like some of my best mates, I was kind of torn because my best mates were going and I wasn't, so I was really chuffed that they got picked, and I knew like how hard everyone had worked to get there, but not being picked for the final squad really hit me. Missing out on the last one, like it's an itch I've got to scratch. Like,
set, up. Lovely, AJ. What about that, dynamism?
And it's kind of stuck with me since. Like, I don't think you'd ever get over it, but time heals. And this year I've had an extra sense of perspective, like having a kid.
Hello. Hi, boy. You look sleepy. How are you? Hello. Come here.
As long as he's all right, everything's not as you don't kind of push it, catastrophize it as much. To get on that plane would kind of mean everything for me, like the sacrifices I'm making at the moment, being away from him and being away from my wife and leaving her in a new house.
Yeah, come on, Russell, you got him, Russ!
Coming back to sevens the last week, my legs and lungs took an absolute battering. And weirdly, my feet, I changed the direction. I had like blood blisters and new blisters. There's nothing that can prepare you for sevens training. So yeah, getting back into that was a bit of a shock to the system.
Where's he spend most of that session? Yeah, just goes to his edge, goes to the edge. There you go.
When you get tired, where do you go?
Edge, yeah.
But I don't want to go on the edge because Rocky's going to think I'm tired. Yeah, all right.
The reason I pictured it was that New Zealand game. You turned over three balls. That's all I had to go on that thing. And you turned over three balls against New Zealand. They don't lose balls in rucks. And that's what I was thinking. If I can get you more in the middle of the field.
No, but
that's the thing. The agility is the key thing.
I'm doing
something. No, okay. But the agility is the key thing. All right? Just something I want you to keep aware of. I'm aware
of it. I'm trying to get there.
Fair enough.
To be with the calibre of players we've got in, I'm like buzzing to be in the mixer and happy to be back with the lads and looking forward to pushing on the next couple of months.
We do the exact same next time as well. Go. Just keep.
Don't play football in private.